Good day, everyone. My name is Coolpilot, and welcome to another episode of the Marrilcraft server. You may already be seeing there's quite a bit of change around here. There's the sponge point over there. I've been hard at work since the last video, both before and after the server was shut down for the previous weekend while Maryland was on vacation. Done a fair bit. Even got a little bit started on the Clocktower. Not too much, just enough to give me a nice little space to work from. But before we get to the Clocktower here, which we will be building more of this episode, let's go over the stuff that I freaking Breezel was. I swear he's literally died to everything at this point. Anyways, so I'll show off some of the stuff I have worked on. First and foremost, I have promised last video to show off my awesome tools. Well, I died. Not by any fault of my own. I was just working on some of the pathways over here. Actually, literally that pathway right there. And I got interrupted by the parents saying that, oh, they had something that they wanted to show me. And oh, this is kind of important and everything. It wasn't important at all. Of zero consequence, actually. Didn't need to see it at all. And because they had to go off and show me that, didn't even have the picture ready to show me, I died to a zombie. But considering it happened like literally 1 minute before I came back on and the items were gone, presumably there was a creeper right behind it. And it blew up all my items. So I lost my amazing helmet, my amazing boots, my amazing pick, as well as a bunch of tools, all my armor, my shield, which, you know, shield's not that big of a deal, and also all the materials I had on me. So I lost quite a bit. I still have not remade my awesome helmet, which was a Respiration 3 Aqua Affinity Protection 3 Unbreaking 3 helmet. An amazing helmet for needing to get all the clay for this thing. Nor have I replaced my boots yet, which were a Depth Starter 3 Protection 3 Unbreaking 3. Also really awesome for gathering clay. Although I do have some enchanting books. I actually go back in here and show it off. In order to, you know, replace the pick I had to spend a bunch of time fishing because I had a mending pick. It took 8 hours to get a freaking mending book. But I got a whole bunch of books in the process. Here I got a Depth Starter 3, Fire Protection 3, which is kind of crummy, but hey, it's something. I just got a whole bunch of stuff here. Here's a Depth Starter 2, Unbreaking 3. Some fortune stuff, a bunch of protection, sharpness. I have even more in here. Like some of the better ones out here. Here's a Depth Starter 3 protection for efficiency 4. Obviously, efficiency 4 would be a lot, but not boots. But if you get Depth Starter 3 protection 4, that's pretty nice. Some other things, like power and stuff. Got a bunch of nice stuff in here, as well as some of the tools that I want to enchant or repair. Here's my original Fortune 3 pick. This is the first one I made. When I went to enchant a second diamond pick to combine it with this one, because I had Unbreaking 3 pop up for the diamond pick, so I was going to combine that with this Fortune 3 and then a mending book to get a cool Fortune 3 Unbreaking mending pick. Well, I ended up getting Fortune 3 Efficiency 4 Unbreaking 3 on that second enchantment, so I didn't even need to combine with it, which was a good thing considering I ended up losing that pick that I also put mending onto later. But I have remade it, and actually, it's even better now. The Magnum Opus. Efficiency 5, Fortune 3, Mending, and Unbreaking 3. Amazing, amazing pick that I can use for pretty much everything, and this thing just heals up really quickly when I'm off in the nether, mining up a bunch of nether quartz. Or mining up a bunch of coal, too. And in the process of all that fishing, I also ended up with a ton of fishing poles and bows with some good enchantments, including mending. So I was able to combine a couple to make Star Void here, my bow. Power 5, Flame Infinity, Punch 2, could be better, could be Punch 3, but hey, Punch 2, Mending, and Unbreaking 3. An almost perfect bow. So, yeah, it's kind of pretty at the moment. Learned my lesson not to allow myself to sit out in the open next time I am interrupted to go someplace safe. But now that I've learned my lesson, I got some awesome tools that will last me for quite some time. I also learned my lesson to keep a water bucket on me at all times, because I was out of diamonds when I had lost all that tools, because I had used them to make, you know, the sword and the axe and the shovel and everything that's in the ender chest, because I wanted to enchant that stuff after I had, you know, made my awesome, amazing pick I would never need to replace. Well, I needed some more to make this new pick, and the diamonds that ended up going to this pick, and that the extras are in the ender chest there, they ended up being in a vat of lava that almost killed me. I was just mining with my old Fortune 3 pick and fell into lava. I was able to get out of it when it was like half my health, and the fire stopped at half a heart, although I was at the bottom of my staircase at that point. So at the start of my tunnels, basically. I have learned my lesson to always keep water bucket on me, just in case. As for buildings, you can see that Azumarill Square is now finished. Your smile, so cute. See all the little bubbles around. So now it very much does look like an Azumarill. I will get a slightly higher view here. Get up a little bit. Ta-da! You can even go a little higher. Ta-da! Nice little Azumarill. It'll look even better from the clock of the top... The clock of the top tower. What am I saying? Top of the clock tower. While we're up here, you can also see that I've started working on the roads a bit. I figured, you know, since I was doing a fairly basic design for the roads, it's just half slabs of the, I think it's called dark oak, if I remember right, should be. Dark oak slabs and stone brick stairs inside, and then these little lamp posts all over the place to help light it up. We'll take a closer look at the lamppost down there. But since I figured, yeah, it's a pretty simple design, and it's a lot of just grilling work, really. It's just slow, busy work. I've decided, I'll do most of that, if not all of that, off-camera, and just focus my camera time to the clock tower, to the actual buildings, because this is something I'm going to be working on for some time, the roads. And it's kind of boring. Kind of boring. The results are nice, but... doesn't make for that great of video work. I have gotten a fair bit of it done already. I'll get this guy too. Let's see, the lampposts here are got that chiseled stone brick, a couple dark oak fences to match the road, and they're nice, also just plain nice and dark. The redstone lamp, some little trap doors here, which we can actually, you know, if you want to, you can extend them out and have them look like this. It looks okay as well, but I like prefer them closed. And some reversed of... what are they called? Light sensors? Daylight sensors, right. Some reversed daylight sensors. You just, you know, right-click them after you place them. Yeah, they're reversed, so that way when it's daylight out, it is... off, and when it's nighttime, it is on. So when it starts to get to night, all of these lights, all these lamps light up, which is nice. Obviously, from Zimwell Square here, we have paths out in forth directions. The main road out that way, the road that will go to the northwest of the island, comes out from here. This road will eventually go to a small dock down here, which I'll build eventually. It'll be another little thing I'll probably do on camera. And then this road is just, like, super short. It just goes straight up to the spawn farm, and that's it. And I got little signs around saying, this way to get to this stuff and this stuff. This way, you know, to village in East Merrill Island. Since this is for the spawn point, I just, you know, do the basic stuff that's most important. Of course, Azumarill Square, by me. Whereas when we get out to here, the clock tower, since this is kind of a... four-way intersection, slightly more specific, so Azumarill Square and the spawn farms, that way. Over here, we have village and north and northeast of Merrill Island, this way, because it'll go off to the north, northeast, and north and northeast of the island. And of course the village, temporary path here, although the permanent path will be like right here to be perfectly in line with the road of the village. And I'll be making that road a little later. And over here, Keep on moving. No, I should probably take this off. Yeah, left it on there accidentally. That was so I could get in and out of the clock tower from this side easily. This way also to the village, because the village is like right there. And East Merrill Island. There will eventually be... I'm over here. Already got up to here. But once you get to here, it'll kind of bridge over this water and go over to there. But it'll be a part of it that'll come out and link up with this this road right here. And if we come back this way, 150 deaths in 6 days. Jesus Christ, Priestle. Get your act together. Quit dying. And this way, the enchanting hub. I spelled that wrong. Let's redo that sign. We have the enchanting hub, the auto fish farm, and the Southeast Merrill Island. Make sure that's capitalized. It's L-A-N-D. It's all spelled correctly? Yes. Okay. And this pathway will go towards the southeast of the island. I will make a little path up to the chanting hub over there at some point. The only one I really have up to the door at this point. Shinx was slain by Rid using Sword of a Thousand Truths. Okay! And here I made a nice little pathway here to the auto fish farm. And then the pathway will keep going over here, and we'll eventually kind of follow this to go out towards that direction, out towards that giant castle. I think Rid's building on that, if I remember right. So, and also kind of cleaned up some of the areas around here, including this little fishing hole. I kept the fishing hole. Might as well. Yeah, it looks kind of nice. But, you know, cleaned up the area, you know, next to the road, filled in some areas, like through here, had to fill up a little bit. But it's all turned out quite nice so far. Super loud eating. I'm guessing that's from the player sounds. I turned player sounds up so I can actually hear footsteps, but I guess eating, it makes eating super loud too. And then we have the clock tower. So around the clock tower, before we actually get to the building itself, these areas are going to be little, not flower gardens. What would you call them? Not flower gardens, not flower fields, flower beds, right. So these will be flower beds all around the clock tower. And originally, the design called for triangular flower beds here at the edges. I've still kept these here just in case I do decide to do that, but I'm thinking of just doing kind of, you know, angled rectangular flower beds, you know, along these edges. I think it'll look a little bit better and take up a little bit less room as well. And then the clock tower here. Got a bed of chiseled sandstone there, and of course the whole bottom aspect will be whole bottom section will be all brick. So we got quite a bit to go. This is what, 6 blocks tall so far. This is gonna go up like 45 blocks. Yeah, we got quite a bit to build. Quite a bit. Now, the design of the clock tower, I will put on screen at the moment. And, of course, this clock tower, as I said, I have built before. It is designed off, well, it is the design for the clock tower for my main comic, The Aberdeen. I actually designed the clock tower in Minecraft. That's how I came up with the design of it. Because I know Minecraft. I'm used to Minecraft. It helps me to come up with designs for stuff, especially for stuff that I am going to be, you're going to be seeing a lot of in the comic. I really want to like try and build in Minecraft, or at least build some, you know, even if it's like a really basic version of the building in Minecraft, just to help with perspective and understanding perspective of things I'm going to be drawing like a million times. You know, I want to make sure I have that down pat, especially something tall like the clock tower or really big like Dragon Hall, or heck, even Main Hall. So the clock tower was the first thing I built for that. And you can see in the design of it, the whole bottom section of the clock tower has three like big archways, you know, going up, you know, up to 45 blocks thereabouts. One addition that was part of the original design for it that I actually took out for the final design was little windows going up through the middle arch. We're going to be adding those back in, so there will be, you know, a space of two, and then we have a space of two for the windows, and there'll be four blocks between every window. And these arches will just keep going like straight up for quite a ways. I forget the exact height. Was it 45 or 47? Well, we're not going to be getting to the top of it today. Definitely not. We do not have enough blocks for that. We have quite a bit of blocks here, but not enough for that. So we are going to just collect all this. I do want to leave one, a full two rows here for when I go to add stuff back in. And we're just going to start building. So, you can see the archways are basically this section. This is the interior wall. Now, the interior wall, I'm not building the full interior wall at the moment. You can see there's spaces here that I'm left out. I'm leaving spaces here. I'm just building enough of the interior wall to make the exterior wall. Because parts of the interior wall, like this and this, are parts of the exterior wall. This is just part of the exterior wall. This will be part of the interior wall. But I don't want to use a bunch of my bricks on the inside wall before I even have the outside done. I want to get the outside done first and then worry about the inside wall. So, we're just building the outside wall. So the arches are here at this level. These are the outside supports. These are the corner supports, basically, of the entire bottom section of the clock tower. And again, this is the interior wall. So we will be needing to also build our staircase up as we go. So let's start that off right away. And take all the torches down. We will be needing to put torches back on here once we have used up all these bricks. Keep monsters from spawning on top. I've actually had monsters spawn in the windows before, so I had to put some torches underneath the windows. All right, and the torch here. And then start building. Start out with the, corners. Because I like to get that up first before we do the arches, just so I don't forget them. All right, over here. And there. And then, of course, I also have to be careful not to fall off. We have no feather falling here. There we go. Gotta scratch my nose in between that. Of course, you itchy nose. Alright. So this we can just go straight up with. And we have one block. So yeah, just going up three will work perfectly all around. Because then this will be the bottom of the next window. I need to take my shield off. Okay, so we can only reach two below us. I gotta remember that. So I think we'll do one full layer. Oops! Ouch. This is why I put that there. Let's just take it back down, though. Okay, back up we go. Put the torch here. Yeah, it's very easy to fall off this thing. So, yeah, I was wanting to take that off. I'll do one layer, and then go around and do two layers all at once. Here, and there we go. And then go back around this way, doing two. And almost all the way around. Nope. Already used up the first two stacks. Doesn't take long when this is all brick. There'll be a little less brick usage at the top half of the clock tower, but since the bottom half of the clock tower is all one section, and the top half of the clock tower is like multiple sections, including the roof, it's just a lot of brick down here. All right. So back up once again. Keep our staircase going. Oops. Didn't mean to put that there. Okay, so now at this point, we have a window. So we're going to probably want to put torches underneath these windows. Keep them lit up. Not in the windows, just underneath. Because we're eventually going to be putting glass in these windows. Nope, not on the window. Not in the window, underneath the window here. So we're going to be putting glass in these eventually. You don't actually want them sitting in it. All right. Now we just got to make sure we leave space for the windows as we go around. Don't kill the shackles. There are a lot of people on at the moment. That many people on, and there's already been, I think, one person that had left. So, yeah, there's a lot of talking going on in chat. And I don't know what 99% of it is, because I'm not paying attention. Alright. And there we go. So then we got to do one full layer after that. Be the kind of just bound the windows in. Oh, threw another couple sacks. Already almost out of brick. See, it doesn't take long. It's going to be kind of, I'm definitely going to have to, I'm going to have to remake the helmets and boots before I go back out and get more clay, because they're pretty much essential to getting clay. Through that stack. Granted, that was a partial stack. Okay, let's see how much more we can get. At this point, I think we do two, just so we don't run out before we've, gone all the way around. This will be the third layer above that window. So it'll be one more layer after this before the next set of windows. All right, now the last stack. And this is not going to make it all the way around, but let's see here. Okay, at least, at minimum, make sure we have the space. Ouch! This is why we have to be careful. those spaces are going to kill me at some point. Take that out. Okay. But yeah, we want to, at minimum, make sure we got the blocks underneath the next set of windows set, so that we can put torches on them, and we'll remember where the next set of windows go. And one more here. And then, I think we'll start on this side, and then just do as much as we can. Might get most of the way through here. One block shy. You know what? We'll grab one more block from the chest just to complete that corner. I don't mind giving up one. Back up we go. And it was over here. That way we can see it from two sides and see the progress from two sides, because the front does look a little bit different thanks to the door. That's one of the other things I had to change. normally not a door there in the actual design of the clock tower. Should put this torch up here. And that torch is in the middle. Yep. Okay. So we got a fair bit more built there. Let's see how it's looking. Because, of course, the door kind of changes things a little bit. Normally, these arches go all the way down to here on the same level on all sides, down to that level. But because the door has to start a little bit higher, I'm not sure if I'm going to keep that window there, that single block window, because normally the it would be, you know, 2 blocks tall, and the bottom would be like that block right there. But I don't want it, the window sitting like right on top of this. You know, I want there to be a full set of blocks there at the bottom of the arch. But I do kind of like how the window, not the window, the door thing came out here. Because I didn't just want to have it just be flat. I wanted to use some stairs here to give it a little bit of some depth, some design to it. And I like how it came out there. It looks kind of nice. See, that's how it looks from this side. Come over to this side. You can see starting to come together a little bit. Just a little bit. Long ways to go, though. God, how tall is this? I think there's, if I remember right, there's 4 windows, so there's still like 2 more levels of windows to go before the top will be like somewhere like up here, so we're maybe about halfway. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Not even halfway. Not even halfway, jeez. Yeah, this is going to take a while just because of resources. But I suppose next time we might go off and get some resources. Well, obviously I'm gonna have to spend some time getting, you know, the helmet and boots remade. Try and get a nice shovel made because currently all I have just the shovel. Because the shovel is this Unbreaking 3. I'd like to get a nice, you know, awesome diamond shovel if I can. I'm not sure what I'm going to do next. I might go out and get some clay, depending on how long it takes me to get the helmets and boots made. Maybe we work on the flower beds. That's a possibility. Maybe we work on one of the bridges. This will probably be the first bridge I actually work on. That's another possibility. I'll figure something out. But for now, that'll be everything. Clocktower is, you know, at least you're starting to get the idea of what it's going to look like. A little bit of the idea. But that will be it for this episode. And I shall see you guys next time.